If anyone were to come to India for just one day, only one day, this is what they will see, hear, smell, taste, and feel. A ton of honking, chaotic street crossers, filthy, smelly trash, overpopulation, litter, 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 homeless dogs, unafraid crows, pollution, goats fighting in the city, homeless beggars, under construction. But there's more to India than just those things. Walk through India for a few months and you'll see the other side of India. It's a whole new world here in India. I feel like Nemo and Dory at times. Just keep swimming and just keep exploring a dazzling place I never knew. You have to see it to believe it. This was most of what I pictured when I wanted to come to India. Bollywood. Boy, was I an idiot. Out of the blue, I decided to jump out of an airplane without any parachutes, hoping I would land somewhere in India alive. I remember thinking, I'm either making the biggest mistake in my life or making the most life-changing decision of my life. Welcome to India. I must confess that I didn't fall in love at first sight with India. Suraj ka naya chehra. India was right here in my face, and every time I blinked and opened my eyes, it was still right here in front of me. This crazy dream of mine has become a reality. Here's the only truth I've learned about India. The only absolute truth about India is that there is no absolute truth. The only way to survive India is to have an open mind. Ever since being in India, my morals and values have been challenged. I used to believe that the only fish that goes with the flow is a dead one. To me, life was all about the power to make my own decisions and go against the current. Being in India was a different story though. The only way to survive India was to go with the flow. In order for humans to survive, we must adjust and adapt to our surroundings. Just do what they do. 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 In this crowded neighborhood in Taliganj was where I found a piece of home away from home. I look outside my window and see a different world, not the world I see back in St. Paul, Minnesota. But that was the whole point, wasn't it? Prince Anwar Shah wrote, the first street name I learned. I've learned a lot of things that I could only learn in India. I've learned to chase the sunset inside an auto rickshaw. I've learned to act in a dramatic Hindu mythological play. I played Kunti, the mother of the eldest three of the Pandava brothers from the Indian epic Mahabharata. This was my first time acting in public, and this will be my last time acting in public. I've learned to use public transportation in a foreign country, using foreign currency in a foreign language. Such as, I've learned how to ride a human rickshaw. I've learned how to ride an auto rickshaw. I've learned how to ride the metro everywhere across the city. I've learned how to ride the city bus. I've learned how to ride a taxi. I haven't learned how to ride a bike though. P.S. Bike equals motorcycle. I've learned to hold my breath when I pass this pee spot. I've learned to live with simple and cheap ice cream. I've learned that this is not called henna, it is called mehendi. I've learned to climb 125 steps of stairs 5 days a week. I've learned how the game cricket is played. I've also learned how big of a deal cricket is to India. India won the Cricket World Cup this year. At the end of the day, I return to Taliganj and try to take in every new thing I've learned that day. Most importantly, I've learned to dance to a Bangla contemporary song. Remember how I said, walk through India for a few months and you'll see the other side of India. Well, this is the other side of India. After 4 months in India, this is what I'm taking away with me. I'm taking with me the Hooghly River, the Rajasthan sand, the city of Kolkata, St. Xavier's College in Kolkata, West Bengal, India. The friends I've made. Park Street. Prince Anwar Shah Road. College Street. The folk arts. Kolkata nights. The metro life. The cheap, tasty sandwiches at the back gate of St. Xavier's. The religious diversity. The banana trees. the jackfruit trees. The coconut trees. All the fresh fruits in general. The various beautiful plants. The wildlife. The breezy rain that cools the hot heat down. The expensive flats that make me feel like I'm in the movie Inception. The randomness. And most definitely, the Cricket World Cup 2011 hosted in India. India took the Cricket World Cup this year. ऐसा देश है मेरा हाँ ऐसा देश है मेरा So this is India.
Diverse India is. The north is completely different from the south, completely different from the west. So there's a common kind of thread that ties them all together, but they're all so different. It's so unique.
To be laid back, even in stressful situations, to always be able to see the positive and to always be able to kind of relax and take a step back, even when everything else is rushing by you.
One thing I have learned is that there is never too much. There's never too much color, too many people, too much anything. It's just, you know, the world can always hold more.
I have learned so much from my Kakima about life relationships and just living in general, so I can't really describe, but I'm going to take my Kakima back. And really just how to be in tune to people, I think, is the biggest thing she's taught me.
One of the biggest things that I was looking for in coming to India is a challenge, and I definitely found that here. Just in everything we do every day, it's a challenge. And as I'm looking ahead to going back home to the US, I'm really realizing what a different level of challenge it is there. And I know it sounds cliche, but it's not going to be as challenging as it is here.
Oh my gosh. The main theme that I've learned is just to maybe open my eyes to everything I see and realize that my world is so small compared to the rest of the world. I will be able to think with more of a broad perspective.
I think one of the main things is I'm going to take back is just how lucky I am to not only be here but for the experiences I had when I was here and the things I get to take home with me, and realize that we have a lot of privileges in America that not other places in the world have. So I'm going to be much more grateful and take more advantage of the things that are presented to us, because we're very, very lucky.
I think I will take back a greater sense of self, myself, just my way that I see myself in the world. Well, the key term, self-awareness.
Okay. I am going to take home with me relationships that I've formed with my classmates and my host parents, and I've made so many great friends and people that I know, so I'm just going to take home relationships, hopefully.
I think for the most part I'm going to just take away the relationships that I have with the Bengali people here, such as my Kakima and Kaku and a few friends from school as well. So I think that's the most meaningful part of this experience for me.
India has definitely stretched me outside of my comfort zone to the point where I'm comfortable being uncomfortable. It's definitely provided me an opportunity to grow in a way that I would never be able to grow. Definitely encouraged and forced, you know, me to do new things and to try new things and meet new people and do all of these things that I would never have done if I were to just be in my comfort zone. India has forced me to bend, but not break. You're gonna miss this. You're gonna want this back. You're gonna wish these days hadn't gone by so fast. These are some good times, so take a good look around. You may not know it now, but you're gonna miss this.
I'm definitely gonna miss this, no doubt. I'll miss India. I'll miss Kolkata. I'll miss Taliganj and this little flat. I'll miss public transportation. I'll miss the mountains. I'll miss the waterfalls. I'll miss the ocean. I'll miss the tea and the tea garden. I'll miss the sunset. I'll miss Jabba Auntie and Ashok Uncle. I'll miss my Bengali friends. And I'll remember that every sunset in India is a sunrise in the United States. I remember thinking, I'm either making the biggest mistake of my life or making the most life-changing decision. I guess now that it's all said and done, it's quite obvious that I've made the most life-changing decision of my life. It's time to return to my U.S. home. I'll be back to my India home soon.